Right, folks, this is the man in Gerardian Rottenberg. That team out here had a proud player list to be from Clarinbridge. With raised their hat to be here today to see where they came from about a few years ago. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to one of the presidents of the club and one of the great stalwarts who was there through thick and thin. And boy, did we have it thin. We might have had thick today until that proudest moment. And it gives me great pleasure to introduce my great friend, a great man from Clarinbridge, Holland, Michal Fogg.
Thank you, Joe. It is a great pleasure for me to stand here this evening to introduce a chairman who I worked with years ago. We had an AGM with 5 minutes. And today, this chairman is chairman of the biggest club in Ireland. And that is Michael Carr. And it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you. And before I hand over,
I would like to congratulate everyone and congratulate the people of Galway and all the supporters who supported us today. The world can come down to something else today. Ladies and gentlemen, make it clear.
All of those bodies are back. What a day! What an absolute day! When we all four said where we came from very far down the line. But today was marvellous. And what a great day we had. We are the All-Ireland Hurling Champions! Hooray! We are Hurling people, and we're here tonight, and we're a proud Hurling parish. We didn't just win it, we won in style. We're a marvellous Hurling team. Proudest day of my life. I am now going to introduce you to the manager of this Hurling team, Michal Donohue. I'm also going to invite up onto this stage two of the most marvellous officers I have ever worked with, Damien McGrath, Secretary, and Pat Lannis, Treasurer. I now give you to Michal Donohue.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great privilege from me and on behalf of the players to welcome Tommy Moore to Clarinbridge for the first time. Firstly, I'd just like to salute the 28 players on the panel for the effort they've given the management team for the last 2 years. And Colin made it today in a massive performance of beating Kilkenny by double score, so I want you to salute the Clarinbridge panel. I'd like to thank the management, my co-management team of Tom Hillibert, Noel Burke, Donald Walsh, Conor Lawless and Tom O'Flynn that asked them to go up on stage. I'd like to thank the club officers for all their support throughout the year. And finally, before I introduce Paul Cannon, I'd like to thank the supporters for everyone in Crow Park today. And especially when we hadn't a great start, we were 4 points down and we needed a bit of support, you definitely were the 16th man, so I thank everyone today. Without further ado, I'd like to introduce our inspirational captain, and I'll introduce the panel for you, and that's the great Paul Cannon. Thanks, Michal. We've been working on a little thing there during the bus journey, and we've a little thing written up on each pair. So some lads are coming out fairly well, and some lads aren't coming out too well. There's a little, just to get the crowd involved, there's a little ritual we've done throughout the year, and it involves a question and an answer. The question is, who are we? The answer is the bridge. The question is, what are we? The answer is winners. So I'm just going to ask the crowd, who are we? And what are we? First guy I have to introduce is Liam Donoghue. Don't be cheering yet, no.
We're a bit worried about him early on in the year, but he joined Weight Watchers and he sorts himself out, and he's not going to be allowed to retire until his voice breaks. That is the great Liam Donoghue.
That's not him. That's Tom Herbert. We'll talk about him later on. Liam, come up here. Give the man the cup. No, he's not getting the mic. We'll be here all night.
Next man up is a cornerback, Conor Ford. Some have accused this man of mistiming a tackle. Others have said he's a reincarnation of Elian Ford. All we know is we call him Conor Ford, Conor J. Ford. Harry Ford. Next man up is our fullback. He's our male model. He likes to sport a pink grip. And I think that's what scared Martin Comfort today. And he held him to only 1 point. So that's Brian Burke. Number five is a man who's ice cool. He wouldn't scratch himself in a league game. And at half time, he had a few harsh words to say to a few lads, so we were scared into going out and giving a performance. We're just glad he didn't see red today. And he's a big fan of True Romance. That is Jamie Kang. Next man is he's due to be married there on the year. He's been a fantastic leader all year. He's a rocket number six. He's had a massive year. He loves to make up his own rules in 110, and he loves his cards. That's Davey Ford. Next man up is Michael Donoghue. He's also known as Mickey Babes and Poohead. He's a man from Bruton. He's got a great paw, and once the season's over now, he's going to start taking the bougie calls again. He's been ignoring them for a while, so he's back in business. Fucking forward. Our next man up is our midfielder, Barry Daly. He's a crowd favourite. He's never had a fry in his life. He's organic. He's almost free range, and he's a super athlete and hurler. Next man up, we call him the Murph Dog. He enjoys his occasional whiskey. He's made a lot of money on Clarinbridge this year through bets. He had backed his heavily against Tennessee, so he had to finish the job himself with that last minute goal. It's Aidan Murphy. Next man up is our number 10. He's the hardest worker on the pitch. He likes to shift wing backs out of the way. That's Shane Burke. Our next player needs no introduction. Our number 11, the man of the match today, the top scorer. He's actually probably having a rub around the corner there with Noel Burke at the minute. He needs a rub every time he beats the young lad at 5 a.m. in the morning. But
He's our leader, he's Mark Kearns.
Find the heart show up the steps there. Next man he's a nephew of Mickey and Red, and Mick will be very proud today. He sports the same shoulders as Mick, and he plays his hurling like he drives his van. It's like he stole it. He might shave the loaf carpet after tonight, after he's won it on Ireland. It's Stevie Ford. Our number 13, I suppose there's one thing we're going through his head today. It was that nothing was going to stop him scoring 1-4 today. Not even the pub in Kinvara. That's Owen Ford. I suppose our next player has had a massive year. He's always a big match player. For some reason though, last night, he took a bit of a turn. He actually tried to knife himself for some reason. I don't know what it was. But luckily he didn't finish the job off right. And he was able to perform today to the highest degree. That is, of course, the great Alan Kearns. The last, I suppose, starting player on the team, he's had some massive games against the likes of Baja and Lockeray, which kept us in the championship. He keeps Galway Airport flying all year long, and he was flying in the corner today. It's Paul Mansell-Cohn. A man who didn't sleep since Monday. He's a great goalie and a great clubman. He's renowned for his 5 a.m. ticks in the morning, inspirational ticks about we're going to do it. That's Noel Conlon.
We are going to go.